Hello everyone, this is Sangeeta and welcome to SAIGM The Art Zone. We just completed the first series of Drawing for Beginners on Lines and Curves. I hope you all have gone through those videos and have practiced them too. Now let's move ahead to the next topic, which is a vital and essential part of drawing, that is perspective drawing. When you transfer your vision in the form of drawing on a paper is perspective drawing. It is the fundamental aspect of drawing and is visible in everything you see. It relates to the real life and is an integral part of drawing, which is inevitable. Let's get into the video to understand it better. Drawing realistically is an illusion of perspective. Rather, we can say that perspective is to create illusional space on a two-dimensional surface. It is important to keep a reality check while drawing objects. It not only gives an idea of dimension of objects, but also gives an idea of how close or far is the object. In perspective drawing, the objects which are nearer appear comparatively larger than the objects which are far. Now let's understand it better. Now I'll draw a simple horizontal line here. This is what is called the horizon line. When we see something, we see it at our eye level. This level will be the horizon line. Horizon level will always be there. Our eye level affects our drawing. Now this is something when we see the objects from the higher level, that is above the horizon line. And this is when you look at the object from down, that is below the horizon line. Now look at the sea. When we see it at our eye level, this is the horizon line. When the eye level is lower, the horizon level is also lower. And when the eye level is above, the horizon level is higher. If you are standing in front of a busy road and you look after the distance, what you see on your horizontal plane is your horizon line. The straight line is obstructed and is not noticed because of all these objects here. But it is there. Now coming back to our horizon line, we will talk about the vanishing point. It is a point that stays on the horizon line. It need not be on the center of the horizon line. The very common example given to show the vanishing point is the railway track. These parallel rails appear to meet at a point in the horizon line. This point is the vanishing point. Again, it need not be on the center. As I said before, the objects near will appear to be bigger than the objects far away. We will further understand in detail about the vanishing point in the upcoming videos on different perspectives. That's all for today. We'll be seeing more on the method of perspective drawing in the coming videos of this series. Until we meet again in the next video, keep practicing lines and curves. Thanks for watching. Take care and bye-bye.